I once heard Akadui mention their Island of the Dead.
I dreamed of my ancestors' halls. They were empty. I dreamed of the North, of an offering left to us by Tukuhama. An offering that will save the Karui. I needed only to take it. I gathered my finest 500. I brought them here. I claimed what Tukuhama had promised me.
Bring the beast in my sights, Exile. You go, little beast! Away!
Beneath the summer sun, we followed Tarkus in search of the promised land. Before long, hunger grips our stomachs, the dreamlands take their toll. Numbers dwindle, and discord spreads among the tribesmen.
allowed not one of my 500 foes. The blood of the ancestors surged in our veins, and each and every one of my warriors earned Tukohama's mark upon their skin. We descended into the heart of Rayclass, and there he came to me, Tukohama. He asked of me a sacrifice. I gave it willingly. My axe fell 500 times, the jade drinking its fill of Kadui blood. Tukohama was pleased.
hunt, Exile. Einar will write a mighty poem about it.
Invited Kitava into this land. The Karui paid the price. Kitava cut us off from the ancestors, raised the remembered as his children, tortured our dreams. Kitava murdered the Karui way. I will found a new way, for I have been chosen. I gather my forces so that I might wage war on Kitava. I am the son of Tukuhama. And I will lead the Karui back to glory.
These shiny baubles we pull out of the rock are worth more than their weight in gold. Yet we hardly get paid at all. We should stop work and demand our fair share. All right.
of Rayclasp, you were infected. Kitava has soaked this land in his filth. I will crush the corruption from your bones. Drain your black blood upon this sacred ground. Brothers and sisters, I honor you with a warrior's death. Your spirits will fight by my side when we march against Kitava. You will be given in service to Tukohama. You will be remembered with glory.
You got a warrior's death, Kaon.
Thank you. What is it, Exile? Do you wish to know?
Purger of corruption.
Thank you.
pried the fury from Calm's dead hand, did you? Or is it dead again hand? Or re-dead hand? Or is undeath really just death with benefits? In which case, you didn't kill Calm because he was already dead. It's all a bit of a grey area, really. And completely beside the point. Yet we're still one gem short. Go, not a cockroach, and relieve Duresso of his desire. Ta-ta, not a cockroach.
The Sword King. It was here in the streets of the darkness. I am dead, killing rabid dogs and wild boars before I could even be considered a man. In this, some glorious arenas, I care nothing for your past, only your future. And for that, you will have to fight.
Beneath the summer sun, we follow Tarkus in search of the promised land. Before long, hunger grips our stomachs. The Doomlands take their toll. Numbers dwindle, and discord spreads among the tribes. There was more to that memory, I'm sure.
Thank you.
Cool and his stinking flock were simply an audition. Let us see how you fare in the grand arena of Theopolis. Arena of Theopolis. At age 13, carving knife in hand, I killed beasts for the amusement of the filthy. At 15, they thought me worthy to fight a fellow man. A butcher he was, twice as big and twice as stupid as I. I butchered the butcher, and many like him. Earned my way, kill by kill, out of the awful pit and into the grand arena. I thought I would find wealth and glory in the arena. I was wrong. I found something far more precious. My Lady Mervale.
I see you. You are here seeking answers, because you can find them only in the stories we will leave behind when Malachi and Vol cause our destruction. In this final hour, I entertain the notion that the words I write exist in some form beyond me. Do they go on as dreams, as memories? I have the wildest notion that perhaps you will find a way to pick up scraps of memory, and you, whoever you are, will come across this one someday. If you do, I ask only this. Slay Malachi. Slay him for yourself, or slay him for all the lost citizens of the Empire. But most of all, slay him for... Exile. I am a mere shade with only figments of memory. I can say with certainty that no man has ever felt the nuances of rage and love so strongly. His was the strongest memory I have ever felt, an imprint of his entire essence. His name is Vitalia.
Thank you.
knelt in the sand of the Grand Arena, awaiting the killing blow. I raised my eyes to look upon my death. Instead, I saw her. Turned my opponent's strike and killed the man with his own dagger. Fighting had always been about survival, the primal instinct to kill or be killed. Now, fighting became about something else. Love.
Thank you. previous King of Swords was a giant of a man, both faster and stronger than I. Yet I needed only look up at my Lady Mervale to know that I had no choice. I could not die this day. I made him shiver under every parry, striking with all of my might so that my arms felt they might snap with every impact. I studied his face, watching for that moment when he began to doubt. It took an hour, but finally, it was there. Burning with pain, empty with exhaustion, I stepped inside his faltering swing, and I slit the giant's throat. I did not take my victory bow. I knelt in the sun, looked to Mervale, and cried out for my lady's hand in marriage. From that day forth, I wore the crown of swords upon my head and the ring of eternal love upon my finger.
A king of swords is nothing. I cannot defend his crown.
Song forever, Duresso. I promise you that.
What is it, Exile?
Welcome. A chest of goods hides many challenges, but one goes unseen, even to the wise.
Welcome.
Yes? I am told that you have put King Calm down to his final rest. Cursebreaker, and now the murderer of legends. Great names hatch upon you like ticks on a roar.
Very good. Nightmare gave Calm everything he ever dreamed of. How did it feel to make that dream die?
Mm-hmm. What is it, Exile?
How can I help?